Hey everybody, it's Dena Stevens from ABetter Realty. Welcome to another episode of Real Life Real Estate Colorado Style. Anyhow, you know I've been doing real estate since about 2004, and most real estate agents have a ton of stories, half of which we can't tell or have to change the names or whatever. Anyhow, I've been thinking about this one for a while now, and it was going to be me telling you that any responsible real estate agent should go look at the property they're representing, either for their buyer or for their seller. The first example I'm going to give you is I had a gentleman call me, said he inherited some property down in the Canyon City area. Would I list it for sale? And I said, since he inherited it, had he ever seen it? And he had not ever seen it, but he was tired of paying taxes on it, which is pretty common. And I said, okay, I'll list it. After some discussion, I went up and took pictures and put a sign in and listed it for sale. And I don't know, a month or two later, somebody came along, decided to buy the property, and he was buying it sight unseen. And I just said the seller hadn't seen it, and now the buyer hadn't seen it. The only person who had ever seen this property was me. So I had them sign all these various disclosures and topography maps and plat maps, and I wanted to make sure that everybody knew what was going on. So I also had him sign a piece of paper that said he wouldn't hold me responsible because he hadn't seen the property, which he did sign that piece of paper. And it all worked out just fine. But here's an example of where the real estate agent really needs to go out and see that property. And I'm convinced most real estate agents do go out and look at the properties they're representing, but on occasion they don't. Another example, hi Jeff. Buyer Jeff called me and said, I want to buy a property. I had already seen it. You don't need to go look at it, Dena. And I said, yeah, I kind of do. If I'm representing it, I want to see the property. I want to know what we're talking about. So this was out of town about an hour, and I went out and looked at it, and it was a very nice property and great views. And we got the deal done, and no problem. Actually, I ended up going to see that property probably 3 times before it closed. So again, I need to go see that property. Even though my buyer said, don't worry about it, I kind of need to know. What if I'm ever called by a judge or somebody else and says, what do you know about the property? What am I going to do? Say I represented the property but never saw it? That's not logical. So again, I'm going to tell you, most real estate agents need to go out and see the property they're representing. Now, having said that, I was representing a property. I had a buyer's agent's assistant show the property. She showed it while I was holding an open house. I know this assistant. I know the buyer's agent. The people bought the house. We went to closing. We're all sitting at the closing table. The buyer and seller are exchanging stories and what key fits here and, you know, how everything works, and everybody's happy. The buyer's agent kind of pipes up and says, oh, I know that neighborhood so well, and on and on and on. And ultimately, the more she spoke, the more everybody at the table realized she'd never seen that house. And I'm thinking, huh, your buyer's agent, you probably should see the house you're representing. All right, now that all being very critical, guess what? Had a man say he wants to sell some property not far from me up in the Cotopaxi area. He has not seen the land in a very long time, many years. He wants to sell the property. I went up to look at it this last week, and guess what? You can't get to the property. This property was subdivided prior to the laws saying you had to have access. Basically, there's got to be a way to get in there. This is way back in the mountains. About as close as I could get was, I'm guessing, about a half a mile. I can't get any farther. I'm not physically able to get closer. I guess I could put on my hiking boots and hike back in there, but I don't know that it's that smart. There's animals back there. Who knows if there's cliffs or, you know, bear traps or whatever. I'm not the one who can take that chance. I want to see the property. I want to be fair. I took pictures all the way up and in the surrounding areas. And if you've ever seen any of my videos on Cotopaxi, you know I'm up there quite a bit. But I can't get to this property. Well, I just told you, I think it's the responsibility of every agent to see the property. Whether they're representing the buyer or the seller, they need to see the property. Guess what? I've already taken the listing, and I can't get to the property. I can get darn close. The seller hasn't seen the property in years. Now, how am I going to tell buyers how to get up there? I'm still working on that. I think I'm going to give some GIS instructions so anybody with a GPS and who knows how to use it can take those, take that information and get to the property. But I can't tell them what to expect to get back there. I don't know if this property's flat or rolling or full of cliffs, if it's got views. I don't know. So anyways, that's my real life real estate Colorado style. Real life real estate Colorado style is what I was trying to say. I hope you learned something from it. Ask a realtor for their funny stories. We all have them. Some, like I said, we just can't repeat. Thanks for watching. Give me a call if I can help you with anything. I'm happy to represent buyers and sellers in your property. And hopefully I can get my boots on the ground and go in and see this property. Y'all have a good day. Call me if I can help. Remember, Dena Stevens, putting the real into Realtor. Have a good day.